Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the new lecture on Pharmaceutics, the Dosage Form Science. I am Shoaib Muhammad, lecturer in the Department of Pharmaceutics, Faculty of Pharmacy, University of Sindh. In this lecture, we will be going into the further details of pharmaceutical calculations and we will be discussing the common systems of measurement and inter-system conversion. This is the outline of the current lecture. Firstly, we will be discussing the common system of measurement. Then we will be discussing apothecary system, our Dubois system, the example, and finally the practice problems for the students. Though the international system of units have been implemented throughout the world, and it is the official system for weights and measures, is stated in the United States Pharmacopoeia, the pharmacist may encounter the common systems that are sometimes used in the pharmacy. So there is need for the recognition of these common systems and to understand how these common systems work. The two of the major common systems that were used into the past include the apothecary system and the Avoirdupois Dupuis system. The apothecary system of measurement is the traditional system of pharmacy, and although it is now largely historic significance, components of these systems are commonly found onto the prescription. So there is still need of the understanding how the apothecary system works, what are the units of the apothecary system is, and how it can be converted into the SI system. The other system which is used is the Avoirdupois system, which is basically common system of the commerce employed along with the SI system into the United States. It is through this system that the items are purchased and sold by the ounce and pound. You might have seen into the various of the commercial industries that they are selling the products by ounces or pounds or gallons. So it is because of these systems that are still being used at some places, and understanding of these systems is very necessary for the pharmacist, because he may encounter the use of these systems into the sale, purchase of the pharmaceutical materials. In the apothecary system, the smallest unit for the measurement of the fluids or liquids is minim, and 60 minims make up a fluid drachm, while 8 fluid drachms make up 1 fluid ounce. 16 fluid ounces will make 1 pint, and 2 pints will make 1 quart, and 4 quarts will make a gallon. In the apothecary system, the inter-unit conversion can be done in this manner as well. So the units of the apothecary system for the measurement of the fluids are gallon, quart, pint, fluid ounce, fluid drachm, and minim. Now, 1 gallon is composed of 4 quarts, and 4 quarts are composed of 8 pints. 8 pints are composed of 128 fluid ounces. 128 fluid ounces are composed of 1024 fluid drachms, and 1024 fluid drachms are composed of 61,440 minims. Similarly, 1 quart is composed of 2 pints. 2 pints are composed of 32 fluid ounces. 32 fluid ounces are made up of 256 fluid drachms, and 256 fluid drachms are made up of 15,360 minims. Similarly, 1 pint is composed of 16 fluid ounces. 16 fluid ounces are composed of 128 fluid drachms, and 128 fluid drains are composed of 7,680 minims. Furthermore, one fluid ounce is composed of 8 fluid drains, and 8 fluid drains are composed of 480 minims. Similarly, one fluid drain is composed of 60 minims. In the apothecary carry system, for the measurement of the weight, the smallest unit is a grain, and 20 grains make up one scruple. When three scruples are combined, they are called as one dram. When 8 drams are combined, they make up 1 ounce. And when 12 ounces are combined, they make 1 pound. Now this can also be written into the table form as 1 pound is equal to 12 ounces, 96 drams, 288 scruple, and 5760 grain. Similarly, 1 ounce is equal to 8 drams, 24 scruple, and 480 grain. Similarly, 1 dram is equal to 3 scruple and 60 grain. Finally, 1 scruple is equal to 20 grain. In the avoirdupois system, pound is taken as a standard unit of weight or mass, and all the other measures are derived from pound. In the avoirdupois system, the smallest unit is grain, and 437.5 grains make 1 ounce avoirdupois, while 16 ounce avoirdupois will make 1 pound avoirdupois, which is equivalent to the 7000 grains. So based on the previous data on the units, this table can be made. The units of the avoirdupois system for the measurement of the weight or mass are pound, ounce, and grains. So 1 pound is made up of 16 ounces, and 16 ounces are made up of 7000 grains, while 1 ounce is composed of 437 grains. So here on this slide, we have equivalents from international system to common system, and from common system to international system for easier understanding and easier calculations. So the equivalents of length include that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeters, and 1 meter is equal to 39.37 inch. In the equivalents of weight, 1 pound is equal to 454 grams, 1 kilogram is equal to 2.2 lb or pound. In the equivalents of volume, 1 ml is equal to 16.23 minim, 1 minim is equal to 0.06 ml, 1 fluid dram is equal to 3.69 ml, 1 fluid ounce is equal to 29.57 ml, 1 pint is equal to 473 ml, 1 quart is equal to 946 ml, 1 gallon in the United States is equal to 3785 ml, and 1 gallon in UK is equal to 4545 ml. So here on this slide, we have an example for the reduction of the units, and it says reduce half ounce, 2 drams, and 1 scruple into grains. Now here, the first sign is of the unit, And the second, the next signs are of the numericals, which are basically into the Roman. So in Roman, double S indicates half, so that indicates half the owns. So owns double S means half the owns, and one is one own is composed of 480 grains. So if we multiply 480 grains, because we are moving from the larger unit to a smaller unit, so we will multiply it, and we will multiply it by 0.5 into 480. So the result will be 240 grains. The next is 2 drams. So 1 dram is equal to 60 grains, and here we have 2 drams, so 2 multiplied by 60 will be equal to 120 grain. Then we have 1 scruple. 1 scruple is equal to 20 grains, so we will multiply it by that, and the result will be 20 grain. If we sum up all these quantities, the sum will be 380 grains. Next example, we have conversion of the unit, and it says convert 0.4 ml to minutes. Now this can be solved by two ways. Solution number one is to achieve the two figure precision. Now in this, as we know that 1 ml is equal to 16.23 minims, so simply we will multiply 16.23 minims with the ml, the quantity of the ml that is given. Now here the quantity of the ml is given as 0.4, so we will multiply 0.4 with 16.23, and the result is 6.492 minim. So 0.4 ml contains 6.492 minims. The next solution is by the solution by proportion. Now in this, as we know that 1 ml is equal to 16.23 minims, so 0.4 ml will be equal to about how many of the minims? So 1 upon 16.23 is equal to 0.2 divided by x. So if we keep the x on one side and the values on other side, we get the answer of 6.492 minim. Now here again we have the example of conversion, and it says the fiber length of sample of purified cotton is 6.35 millimeter. Express the length in inches. Now as we know that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter, and the length of fiber is given here in millimeter, and it is 6.35 millimeter. So we will convert this length from millimeter to the centimeter, and as the centimeter is a larger unit, so we will divide the 6.35 with 10, as 1 centimeter is equal to the 10 millimeters. So if we divide 6.35 with 10, we will get the answer of 0.635 centimeter. So 6.35 millimeter r is equal to 0.65 centimeter. Now as we know that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter, so there will be how many inches in 0.635 centimeters? If we keep the value of x on one side and take the other values on the other side of the equation, the equation will be x is equal to 0.635 multiplied by 1 divided by 2.54, and the answer will be x is equal to 0.250 inches. So 6.35 millimeters are equal to 0.250 inches. So here are the practice problems for the students that will be done by the students themselves. So this is all from my side. Thank you very much for your time.